Mark Langa, ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
Morning, Brian.
How are you, man?
Fine, thanks.
Are you?
First of all, you're going to teach me how you do this thing because, yeah. What's the technique?
Well, basically, it's all about blowing and opening and closing the holes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Ah! It's very simple.
Okay, we'll get into that later. But, many, you know, we've seen you around doing a lot of this, especially in church. Mm-hmm. Where did Mark Langa learn this thing? How did you start your journey as a saxophonist?
Well, believe it or not. Would,
is it right to call you a saxophonist or instrumentalist?
Both. Saxophonist, okay. And instrument. Yeah. Believe it or not, I started on piano. Piano was the first instrument that I started learning how to play.
Wow.
But I didn't go very far with it. But it kind of gave me like my grounding in music or the basics in music. Mm-hmm. And not very long after that, I really developed a passion for wind instruments,
okay.
Starting with the flute and clarinet.
Uh-huh.
And I got an opportunity to start learning how to play them. And about 8 years ago, I got my first saxophone, and I started learning. And really, I've been lucky. Maybe a combination of luck, passion, and determination has enabled me to learn. Because I'm self-taught. So no one, I never had a teacher.
Are you serious?
No.
Yeah. Wow, you're so skilled at that. We've seen the. Literally the transformation of what we'd call jazz music to you know, from Isaiah Katumwa's, guys like you. Was Isaiah one of your inspiration here, or you're looking to the international guys too?
Well, before I met Isaiah, or before I knew about Isaiah Katumwa, I had I listened to a CD. I must have been about 10 or 11 years old, of Kenny G. And I remember feeling like at some point in my life, I really want to be able to do that. And I had no idea how long it would take, but I was determined, I was sure that even if it took me until I'm a 70-year-old man, to be able to play like he
You'd
could,
have to do it.
It would be worth it. It would definitely be worth it. Yeah, so I think more than anyone else, Kenny G really inspired me with the smoothness and the sweetness of his approach to saxophone. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, this instrument is obviously, I'm sure it takes a lot of time to learn, but you also play a flute?
Yes, that's right.
Do you have it here?
Yeah.
Is it the same technique that you use to play the saxophone, or is it a bit different?
It's the fingering is quite similar, though the blowing is different.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Remember when we were young and used to blow on bottles?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. You don't blow directly into, but there's just the right angle that you blow at. That's how you play the flute.
Right.
Yeah. Whereas on the saxophone, you're blowing directly into the mouthpiece. Yeah.
Right.
But they're similar, but they're kind of different.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, you've seen the evolution of music in Uganda, and now you guys, it's like the in thing, jazz music. It's like so dope. If you don't, you know, at the Serena here, when there's a jazz safari, this place is packed to the rafters. Do you see that Ugandans are now embracing this kind of music? Or it's still for the corporate world? You guys perform only in places where the corporate people, you know.
I think what I can say about that is, I mean, people always appreciate something good, whatever shape or form it takes. And jazz, I think jazz is like that. Otherwise, I wouldn't like it, obviously.
Yeah, yeah.
But you see the same thing, even for classical music. There's a renaissance, or there's a real appreciation for classical music. Today, I mean, you have events like connoisseurs and so on and so forth. And people really come out and people really appreciate it. And yeah, jazz is definitely on an upward trend.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess because people appreciate it, it's relaxed. It's most of the time easy listening.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. People put a lot of thought.
It's the kind of music that you want to listen to on a Sunday afternoon after eating heavy chimere and you just want to zone out.
Yes, yes. I think that's one of the properties of jazz. It's easy listening. It doesn't take a lot of effort to listen, and it aids digestion and things like that. I'm guessing
it aids lots of things.
Yes,
I've seen you at weddings where you've performed songs. Do you write your own music? Have you released any songs?
Yeah, I have written some songs, and actually right now I'm currently part of a group called Sensation. Mm-hmm. It's a duet, two people, myself and a gentleman called Albert Kukwesiga, who plays everything. He plays the keys, he plays the guitar, and he's also an excellent producer. Right. And we have an album together.
Okay, so this guy is, I think, if you've been trending a lot on Facebook and Twitter, he's Al Shizzo, right?
That's right.
Al Shizzo. Excellent, you know, instrumentalist. He plays everything. Oh, yes. You guys are a lethal duet.
Yeah.
All right. So go on.
Yeah. I was just saying we have an album together, which came out last year, and yeah, we have some of our own songs and that sort of thing.
Wow. Mm-hmm. What are some of the? Do you just look at Kenny G? Do you have any people that you would at least before I die I want to do this?
Kenny G would be the guy.
That would be your lifetime achievement.
Not so much. Of course, the fame, popularity, and that sort of thing. But I love the way he approaches the instrument. I love the clarity, and yet also the fluidity with which he plays and the smoothness of his tone. It's something that I guess shows up in my own sound, or that you can pick up traces of. But not only him, because he's just one person. There are lots of other saxophonists that I look up to. It's a guy called Kirk Whalum. Yeah. This guy, I mean, just has soul. You can almost feel it. It's as if he's singing through the instrument.
Awesome.
And I mean, there's so many.
That's what you're working to, you know.
Yes, I'd like to pick out a little bit of the best of everyone and see if I can blend it into one. I mean, one sound, one image, one person. Yeah.
All right. So you want to do a tune? I've had you, I think, performing one of these a rendition of a Ugandan song here. Forgetting the title.
I'm going to play one of our own originals. It's called Okwagala.
Awesome. Okwagala.
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 Yes.
Take it away.
Because something like this.
Do you want to face these guys? All right.
So it goes.
Really, I was going to do a remix. So I've been checking out some mm-hmm. messages on Twitter, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. someone is asking you, James is saying, can he do something Nera, a rendition of Nera? And I've watched you do that before.
Oh, really?
Yes, so you have to do it.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Sure.
Yeah, that's how you play a saxophone. Fantastic. Okay. So I also have in my hands, and this is what you call a flute.
That's a flute, yes.
This doesn't look like the traditional flute.
Yeah. You know, an interesting fact. Mm-hmm. Every culture in the world has its version of the flute.
Oh.
And even in Uganda, we have what we call omulede.
Yes, the yeah. bamboo thing.
Yes. Uh-huh. And everywhere you go around the world, you find a flute, and there's certain instruments which you always find. You find drums,
uh-huh.
yeah, and I think it's something about our DNA as human beings.
Right.
We yeah, but this is what you'd call a concert flute in C,
mm-hmm.
and it was actually the first wind instrument that I learned how to play.
This one.
Yep.
All right, man. Do it. Let me just take this
no problem.
Off you, and you get that mic. This thing is actually heavy.
Yeah. I think you can see how mugged I've become. Put this down. I'm going to ask you
mm-hmm.
very kindly to just hold the microphone on the back here.
Right here. Mm-hmm. Okay. I think you should like add me in the group Sensation. I'll be the beatboxer or something.
Definitely. You definitely have potential. We have audition sometime this week.
So are you planning, do you also have an album for the flute or?
On the album that we have, which is called The Real Deal, mm-hmm. we have a one flute track, which is what I played.
Wonderful.
And it's called Tumwebaze.
Wow.
Yeah.
Many people have looked at you guys and they've said, mm-hmm. well, you're only concentrating about yourselves mm-hmm. and will not probably leave a legacy behind. And a guy mm-hmm. will die. And say, so who was he mentoring? Is there anyone who will mm-hmm. be like mm-hmm. the next Mark Langa? Mm-hmm. Are you mm-hmm. mentoring some people? Are you training some people? Do you mm-hmm. do you offer lessons to guys who want
yes,
to
I,
learn?
Yes, I do. Mm-hmm. I'm actually most of the time a teacher. I only perform on like on the weekends and stuff like that.
Okay.
But I teach at Kampala Music School.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And I have a number of students, and I teach all the instruments that I play, which include flute, okay. Saxophone, and clarinet as well.
All right.
And yeah, so I do a lot of. I actually do more teaching than performing.
Than performing.
Yes.
All right. So before you go, I want you to teach me how to do one of these. So which one?
Okay. Let's.
Is
let's,
much
let's,
easier.
Let's,
the flute.
Let's try the flute.
Okay.
So what happens mm-hmm. is that your left hand mm-hmm. goes comes this side, mm-hmm. something like that. So you put your thumb there.
Right.
First finger here. Mm-hmm. Skip this key. Next finger goes.
Are these a constant? You have to keep your fingers on these.
Well, they have to be in that position.
Okay.
So this other hand goes somewhere here. This finger goes there, there, there.
So yep. It's always like this.
Yes. Now you, if I could demonstrate on this, mm-hmm. which, if you realize, is actually quite similar, the positions.
Yeah.
So you'll be lifting. And putting down your fingers at particular times, but they'll stay in the same position.
They always come back to
yes.
this.
So like each finger is assigned to a particular hole or a particular key.
Okay.
Yeah.
There are those that are not okay.
Yeah. Yeah. So basically, you'll be opening and closing them from this way going down.
Mm.
So they'll start out all open, and then you go closing them in order. Or opening them in the opposite way.
All right.
Yeah.
So we go for it.
All right.
All right.
Now that's the whole that's the holding part. The blowing part is a
different.
Yeah. Now, okay. You want to place just the edge of your lip against the hole.
Right there.
Until you can feel the edge of the yep, something like that.
Mm-hmm. That.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And do a letter P. Not a letter O, not letter O, but letter P. Yeah. So, give it a nice blow.
Like I just blow into it.
Uh huh.
But letter P.
Mm-hmm. Try and make just a small hole. There you go.
Oh, yes.
Promising flutist.
Acclaimed flutist.
Yeah, give it like 5 more years. Wow.
Okay, let me just do this one. Are my fingers placed right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You're good? Try changing the position just a little bit back and forward.
Okay,
until you find the perfect spot. You'll be good. You'll be good.
I'll do something.
It's a very promising start.
All right. That's Mark Langa. Go to his Facebook page, right?
Yep, Mark Langa.
Mark Langa. And if you want to get in touch with us, I will definitely hook you up with his contacts. And you can take him at a gig where you are. And we'll upload this clip very soon on YouTube if you just caught the last seconds of it. Yeah. On Twitter. Are you on Twitter?
No, I'm not on Twitter.
Dude.
But you can find us on Reverb Nation, all Sensation.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just search for Sensation, and you find us on Reverb Nation. And all the songs that I played today
are there. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, that's all we had for you this morning on Everyday Life. Make sure that this morning, this year, you go and learn an instrument. This year, I'm promising myself that I'll learn drums.
Uh-huh.
And now, added to my list is the flute. Stay with us.
It in this.